Hi guys, today we are talking about the Vespa PX carburetor. What are the details? How it is assembled? The Vespa PX scooter has a two-stroke engine with an SI carburetor. This carburetor ensures the optimal fuel-air mixture the engine needs to run. The optimal stoichiometric mixture is achieved when 40.7 kg of air is added to 1 kg of gasoline. Here's a schematic diagram. When the fuel tap is open, the fuel flows into the carburetor through the fuel filter and through the open valve. This fills the reservoir around the float until a level is reached that is sufficient to supply all the jets. The float needle, raised by the float, then reduces or stops the fuel flow to maintain this fluid level. The jets then form the required mixture of fuel and air. The fuel enters the two jets from below and the air from above. The idle jet is responsible for the mixture formation in the low and mid-range engine speeds. The idle jet is responsible for the mixture formation in the low and mid-range engine speed ranges. The main jet does the same in the high engine speed range. The idle mixture adjustment screw ensures that the necessary mixture formation at idle. The throttle slide partially blocks the intake port, depending on the position of the throttle grip, to achieve the desired engine speed. The idle setting screw ensures a certain minimum opening of the throttle slide so that sufficient air can flow in at idle. When the choke lever is pulled, the choke piston opens the way for the air and fuel. The choke jet then creates the additional mixture which is needed to enrich the mixture when the engine is cold. How is the carburetor assembled? After my carburetor clogged, I needed to clear it somehow. Without an ultrasonic bath or compressed air, I needed an alternative. I disassembled the carburetor and boiled it in demineralized water for an hour. I hope this dissolved the jelly-like residue in the passage to the idle jet. Then let's test whether the passages between the float chamber and the main jet and from there to the idle jet bore are clear again. I want to use this squeeze bottle of demineralized water for this purpose. The water should be filled into the bore for the idle jet, specifically this one. The bores are connected to the float chamber via small channels. Yay! The water is flowing to the main jet and then into the float chamber. Yippee! The clogged channels that were preventing the Vespa PX from starting are clearly clear again. What a relief! Then I don't need an ultrasound machine after all. I simply eject the water out of the carburetor again. Centrifugal force makes it possible. Then I can reassemble the carburetor step by step. This is the float needle. This is where it's home.
Home sweet home.
Before installation, it's a good idea to check the tip for damage. If you see roughened or worn spots, you need a new carburetor needle. This one is still perfect. Here's the float. It must be absolutely tight. It must not have any cracks or anything similar. If you suspect something is wrong, you could simply test the float in a bowl of water. If it fills with water when pressed below the waterline, it's defective. This is how it moves with changing liquid levels. This pin holds everything together. Before I can install this, the gasket must first be installed. This is the old gasket. I still have a gasket for the COSA carburetor from an old gasket kit, but I can adjust that. This is the old fuel filter. You can see how it has turned yellow. It has also shrunk, as you can see here. So I will install the new filter. Then the cover can be installed. This is the shaft that holds the throttle slide and spring. I lubricate the guides with grease so everything slides better. Now it's time for the choke unit. I also lightly coat the piston with grease. You can see how the piston opens and closes the opening. This is the idle jet. This is the main jet assembly. I screw this in gently, carefully. This is the idle mixture screw. According to the textbook, it must be carefully screwed in until it stops and then unscrewed 2 turns for new models and 1.5 turns for older models. Well, in my experience, the tip must be flush with the surrounding wall. This is the idle adjustment screw. You can see how the throttle slide opens the further I turn the screw in. I only loosely mounted the fuel bencher, as I would have to remove it during installation anyway. Okay, then the carburetor is ready for use. And I hope you have been well informed or entertained so far. If so, I would appreciate a small donation, a thumbs up and a nice comment. Your like and comment helps me demonstrate to the algorithm that my channel offers good content. If you're not already a valued subscriber, you have now the chance to become one. Check out my playlists for more interesting videos. Have a great time. See you in the next video. Bye bye. I'm not afraid to die.